What up, what up, what up? How you doing, guys? I hope you guys are doing fabulous regardless of where you find yourself. You know that's my favorite word, and that is just to greet you, because I know you guys are many to follow me. All right, right now, so today I came to you once again for a brand new video, and it's all about Bantu knot, and that's the one I have right now on my head. And so I thought to myself, why not take on this challenge, because I've never done it before. I mean, when I said never, I mean the last time I did it, that was like long time ago when my mom did it on my head, and that was yeah, you know what I'm saying. So I had to take that on board and go to school with it. I know nothing about it, and we know how much there's so much culture into this amazing Bantu knot. So I decided to do it only because I've seen so many people doing it, stars, Rihanna, here and there, and so I'm like, why not take on this challenge to do it and see how it really looks on me, guys. So if you are new to my channel and then you've never seen me before, I please would like to ask you, do subscribe. And if you're already part of my channel, part of the family, then I'll say, oh, welcome to the family. All right, so tell a friend to tell a friend to connect, and I'm not gonna take too much of your time because I know you probably want to find out like how I did it, or maybe you already know, but you know, we all have our own way how to do it. So take a deep breath, hold on yourself, don't click out, that's all I'm saying, don't click out, keep on watching because there's so much more to come. Yeah. All right, starting with unraveling what we have underneath the cap, and that is my hair. My hair is absolutely washed with shampoo and conditioner, so the only thing that I had to do is blow drying my hair, of course, so it can dry up, you know, really nicely and smoothly, you know, so I can be able to begin my hair, you know, how it's supposed to be. All right, moving forward, the first thing to do as soon as you shampoo and conditioner and blow dried is moisturizing your hair, and that can be done with any type of oil that you possibly want to or feel like, and you feel like that is the right thing to for you to put on your scalp, because we're all different. And whether it is argan oil, whether it is coconut oil, I mean, regardless what kind of grease it is, like, you can use that for your scalp now. But that is really an essential step for you to do, only because if you don't moisturize your scalp, then your scalp will get dry, and if it dried, then your hair will not look healthy. It will just look like you done it, I don't know, weeks ago, and you probably will start itching. And when you itch, then obviously your hair will not last as long as in the long run, you know, it's just not going to last at all. So after moisturizing your scalp, what you need to do is massaging your hair, not just your hair but your scalp, only because that helps you to spread out the grease or the oil that you just applied on your hair. And it's always a good step to do, one of the good steps to do is when you warm your oil before applying it on your scalp. That literally helps the oil to, or the grease to, penetrate your scalp really quickly and better. So now what I'm gonna do is to parting my hair, as the shape that I'm going to be using is triangles. So I find it easier to parten the hair at the front first, in the first part of my head, because that is what I'm seeing, right? Even though I have two mirror, and that is just me. Like, if you're just like me and you constantly to just rely on you just doing your hair without mirror at your back, then it's always good to be using two mirrors. All right, so I use two mirrors, and that is since forever I've been using that, and it's really been helping me, honestly. That is since I was, I believe, 14 or 15 that I've been doing it on my own. And so if you can rely on your hands only, all right, to do your hair, then that's good. But if you can't, then this is always a good step. So firstly, first cutting the first part of my hair and then dividing it in triangles. What I choose to do is also have five Bantu knot at the front, and then the rest just as it goes, honestly. But I wanted five at the front. Yeah, so I'm trying to get the to make sure that my scalp is really clean. What you're going to be using as well is the Rattail comb, and Rattail comb is something really important and essential as well to help you cut, not cut but divide the hair properly and nicely. If you don't know how to use this tool, I don't know how to really help you out, but a Rattail comb, like when you use it and you don't cut the line nicely, honestly, your hairstyle will just going to be looking like you've been, you know, you've done it like 2 weeks ago, you know. So it's very, very important to use this tool nicely and properly. So someone who's looking at your hair, they're not going to be wondering when you've done it. They'll probably, as soon as you see, they see your hair, and if your hair is new, they will know straight away that your hair, you know, was probably done like either today or yesterday, or just probably in the same week. Well, in a week it'll probably look like already, but you know, not old, but yeah, you know what I'm saying. Anyway, so now we're going towards the back, and I'm using my brush to comb my hair, and you can use any type of other brushes that you need or you want. Honestly, it's just a preference. So I'm trying to locate my line according to the other lines that I've already done. That is also a tool for you to use if you also, if you want your lines to be nicely placed. It's always good when the lines are, you know, they connect. That's the word. When the line connects, it's always good. All right. So I can spend literally time trying my best to make the line nicely, only because I know that part is very important. All right. So, one more time, yeah. Mm-hmm. All right, so this time I'm just dividing the hair in two at the back, only because I just felt like doing three would be just too much and it will make the triangle smaller. So I just thought, okay, you know what, let me just keep it in square instead. And then, you know, the next row will be triangles instead. So, because I wanted the bantu knot to be, how do I say this? Not too small, but quite medium size. I'll say medium or jumbo medium-ish, because there's bigger than this. There's literally bigger than this. All right. Making this line was a little bit crucial because my hair is literally, it's not short, but it's medium short. So I had to make sure that like I'm connecting the dots really, really nicely. Here I already parted most of the triangles, and it's all connecting somehow. I mean, that's how I wanted it anyway. So first step for me was to put all the, you know, the elastic bands underneath, so I know how many bantu knots I'm going to be working on. And yeah, so the size of the braid, honestly, is up to you. It's not up to anybody else. It's really up to you. You've probably seen it somewhere, maybe like the person you've seen had it big, you know, or had a small, whatever. So
I prefer to do medium only because I don't want to have it huge on my head. Honestly, I didn't want to look like some next pineapple or I don't know what. So what I'm using right now is gummy gel. It's not gel, but it's wax, and that's because like gummy truly helps me to slay my hair underneath, and to help me grab the hair nicely, really, really nicely. I mean, I haven't yet seen any other wax, product that really helps me to sleek my hair like gummy. I haven't seen, even though with gummy, like sometimes if you use it too much or so, like it flakes, you know. So I haven't used another one just like this and that doesn't flake. So I try my best to put as little as I can, knowing as well my hair is natural, so it's crazy. So I place it all around and then I comb just to make sure that all the hair is really nicely grabbed. And the next step of course is to add the elastic band. Right now I'm using only one elastic band, but as I'm going I realized that using two elastic band would be better, and only because like it makes it even stronger, right? It makes it stronger. So because if you use one, sometimes it tends to just break, but when you do use it just one, then two, it sticks. So right now I'm using crochet stick. I slide it in between the hair, not my natural hair, and now I pulled the expression in between, and then I choose to twist instead of braiding, only because of experimenting. Sometimes I just like to do things just to experiment, just to see how it's gonna come out. So my hair has been cut quite blank, and so there's no like what's it called, because it's blank, it comes out a little bit out of the twist, but I find it okay. I don't know why, I just find it okay to continue twisting and see really how it's gonna come out, honestly. So one thing I'll also say is like when you place the rubber band, do not do it too tight, only because you're going to regret it later on. As soon as you place your hair and start twisting or braiding and wrap it all around, it makes basically the hair, your hair underneath, tighter. And the tighter it is, the more painful it is, you know, it's going to be for you, because you don't want it to be too tight or too painful. No one wants to get their hair done and have it really, you know, feeling all the pain, basically. Like you don't want to, you really don't. For all the clients that I've had so far, they all told me if it's too tight, they always end up taking it off because the head is really, really hurting them or paining them. So you really don't want your hair to be too tight, all right? Because that is going to stop you from sleeping, and you may probably just keep the hairstyle for one day or just couple hours and pay all the money. Honestly, it's not worth it. So right now I'm twisting again, and I'm noticing obviously my hair is coming out, so I'm adding the gummy on the place where my hair is coming out, just so it can be, you know, be sticked inside, or just trying to control the hair a little bit more. Let's just say that. That's why it's called edge control. Boom. Or let me say hair control. It really does control the hair. Right now you can also choose to twist or to braid your hair till the end of the hair that you're doing, but it's always best to kind of go to where your hair is ending and then from then twisting it like differently from the real twist. I don't know how to say, but just doing it how I'm doing right now. twisting it and wrap it all around. So I try really to do that, which is quite fun to do actually. this hairstyle literally takes you roughly around 2 hours, 2 hours, 2 hours to do. It depends really how slow or how fast you go. So, and it depends how many a part of the hair, I mean how many Bantu knot you want on your hair, right? So I haven't even count how many I wanted, but probably towards the end I will tell you how many I had. But yeah, and the other thing as well, having a brush and what's called slick brush truly helps you, honestly it does. If you don't have like a toothbrush that you're not using, and that helps you for your edge control, for your edge control, then that is what you can use. Apart from that, it's always good to have like a slick brush that is a bit medium-ish, you know. Bigger than this honestly doesn't help. And it's always good to always brush the hair at the extension that you're about to put in, right? Because you don't want it to be like tangling all around. So yeah, slicked in, make sure that you divide the hair in between it, I mean your hair, your natural hair, in two, if twist is what you want, right? So, and adding edge control only because it's controlling the hair, like I said, like for it not to pop out or to come out. Alright, so if you twist your hair, it's on itself really nicely and tight. What happened is like when you try to wrap it all around, it takes the form itself, like it really does. It's really nice. But if you don't wrap it nicely, I mean twist itself nicely or tight, then you have to do the work on your own, like retwist it and stuff. But when you tie it really like really strong, it really takes the shape on your hair. Like I don't know how to explain it, but yeah, that's basically it. So I just thought, okay, you know, twisting is really helping for me. It's helping me done, so I just continue to twist. And I believe I'm gonna switch soon, actually, because I wanted to see how with the braiding goes, actually, or how it's gonna look like if I braid instead of twisting. So this one is the last one before doing the ones at the front. And I just feel like with this one, it's always to pull when you pulling the hair or pulling the expression or impression hair, you know, the last bit towards the end, you know, it's always good to have that. If your hair is blankly cut and you haven't pulled the hair nicely, then you won't be able to twist it around. Like you won't be able to wrap it around your hair and it will stick. You're always gonna like come out. So make sure that when you are pulling your hair or pulling the extension before using it, that you pull it nicely, so you have that what's it called, I don't know how to explain it in English, but yeah, anyway, so now we're doing the front part, guys. We're nearly done, and like I said, do not use too much of the gel. As you can tell, I don't have much of my edges. That's been a question for some time. It's been like that. So I'm not trying to break it even more. So what I'm doing is really important to leave your what's it called, your hair, your baby hair, at the front. Only that is going to help you to slick it nicely later on. All right, cool. And the other thing I wanted to say, like when you're grabbing the hair to place, like to tie, how to say it, when you're grabbing the hair, and you want to place your elastic band, make sure that you grab it in the middle, like, because there's different ways of, you know, of grabbing the hair. You may grab the hair and but you didn't realize that the knot is basically not in the middle, but it's like low, or it's at the back, or, you know, it's on the side. But when you do it like right in the middle, then it looks nicer, and then you can literally see the triangle, or you can see any of the shapes that you basically already traced. So this is why, like, when I'm grabbing my head, just like now, like my hand is literally in the middle. It's not towards the back or towards the front or towards the sides and stuff. And if I'm not doing it properly, so this is why I'm literally like redoing it again and again, just to make sure that, okay, it's literally in the middle. Yeah. All right. Now I'm just gonna repeat the same thing, so I'm gonna stay a bit quiet. Ah, there you go. All right, so I finished with the other two, and now I'm just taking some hair off. Once again, I didn't want to grab this one because no point, honestly. I actually just really wanted to design some nice design at the front. So yeah, there you go. Just two elastic band and just tighten it nicely right in the middle. Boom. That's actually a nice hairstyle. It's actually a nice hairstyle, but no, girl, I'm not gonna go out like this. You're not going to see me walking like this outside. Alright, so the hair expression that I'm using is basically two colors, 1B and color 4, I believe, only because I dyed my hair. So you can use any color of the hair that you want. You feel like, hey, let me rock it, and it will look amazing. It's always good to experiment. Like, I'm all about experimenting when it comes to my hair. So, and because I know it's temporary, anything that's temporary, well, you know, you can always rock it, right? So right now I'm just grabbing the hair again. One thing I wanted to say is, like, do it just like, okay, when you're pulling the hair inside or inserting inside, always leave some space inside, in between. That can literally help you to pull the hair, because sometimes when you pull the hair, it will literally, it's not gonna look nice. You're gonna have to end up brushing the hair again. So I'm probably gonna do it again. I'll show you where or what I mean, basically. So I'm adding again some edge control, just to control my hair a little more. Okay. And twisting it around and then wrapping. Oh yeah, and one thing as well, like when you're twisting or wrapping the hair all around, what you need to do as well is try not to stay at the bottom as you're wrapping around. Try to go a little bit high up, like up and down, only because you want a certain shape. You don't want a triangle shape. Like if you keep it on the bottom, I feel like it starts tightening up, first of all, your scalp, which is painful, and then it will look a bit like a triangle shape ish. So trying to go like up and down, just to like to have a nice so like a pillar shape, like not pillow but pillar, you know, like, yeah, in a sense. Again, I believe I'm making sense. Alright. So I'm gonna show you again what I mean by pulling the hair. So brushing the hair, you grab your stick, put the hair inside, and you leave it, separate the hair, you have a little bit some space in it, and then you pull. Right, that's basically what I mean. Okay, this time around I believe I'm gonna do some of the braiding. And this is the twist again. Alright. As you can tell, my hair is not really blankly cut at the front and it's longer than the back, but I'm still using the edge controls just to control the hair that I'm twisting, only because that it can still end up, you know, coming out. And when you're wrapping the hair around, take your time, don't just rush it, because sometimes like you might end up like doing it over like again and again and again and again, like you don't want that. So take your time and just wrap it around, and the last bits always go towards the bottom and go round, and then that's it. And now I'm doing the last one. Starting in this, the crochet stick, touching the hair and pulling. I have a little bit some space in it and I'm pulling the hair. Alright, always hold the other hair, and then when you pull, it always stick in, like it always does. So right now I'm doing, instead of the twisting, I'm braiding, and I just really want to see, okay, how is this one going to come out? So yeah. For those who don't know how to braid, well, I don't know how to explain to you. I'm sure there's some videos on YouTube. They can literally show you how to braid. It's really nicely and simple. Well, I'll also say simple because I know how to do it. But when you take your time to learn, well, it's always nice and practical. You'll probably end up doing it again and again. So braiding is nice. It's all right. There you go. I'm done. Oh my god. I look different. Like I haven't done this in a very, very long time. Very, very long time. So now I'm using edge control only because I told you guys it's all about controlling your edges, and I like to do my design of the front. So I mean, I'm not professional, but I try. I really do try. And this is where like your slick brush always come in hand. Right. And because I dyed my hair so like brown, like when you slick it, it's like you can see it, like you cannot see it. It's a bit like, you know, but if my hair was a bit darker, probably would have seen it a little bit better, but So for those who don't know how to do the, what's it called, the design, honestly, it's not a biggie. It's really not that like important point for you to do it. But if you don't know how to do it, then there's also some tutorials like on YouTube. And if for those who want me to like show them how I do it, then obviously I'll do a video for you guys. Just need to like comment down below, let me know whether you want me to show you how I do it. But it's really pretty simple. You just need to follow like the brush and your hand, basically. Wherever your hand is going, that's where your thumb is going. Like if it's going in around, then your finger's also going around. So yeah, because if you don't do it like that, honestly I feel like gummy like will leave you with some marks, some flaky blue stuff. But anyway, so I'm done. As you can tell, it dries really quick. That's what I like about gummy. Damn, sometimes the name just goes away out of my head. Anyway, so right now I choose to add gel only because I really want it to stay longer. And so I'm using a gel called Pink, and that this pink has been there. I mean, this gel has been there for quite some time, really, really a long time. So I know this gel since I was really little. So so I added this in just so I can be able to look cute and keep it longer. All right, now I'm using Oil Sheen hairspray, and it's called Argan oil. Yeah, trying to spray in between the lines so it's moisturized. And I believe the last thing you can do also is spray it on. Yes.
So how was the video? Did you like it? Because honestly, I try my best to put, how do I say this, to keep it short, all right? Because it can definitely be long if you do it really slow, if you take your time. Where not, I mean, Bantu not, what I can say is like it can take approximately an hour and a half to 2 hours. That is like if you're really putting your heart and your hands into it, that can really take around an hour and a half to 2 hours. But if you're really doing slow, then it takes definitely longer. So I try my best really to get to the right places, to places that you need the most to see, honestly. So I hope it really helped you. And in case you are interested to do the Bantu knot and you're like, okay, you know how to do it, blah 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 blah, well, I can definitely tell you that the product. Sorry, I tend to, snap out or forget the words that I'm supposed to say. So I got all the product here next to me, and just want to show you quickly the things I've used basically to help me out to, to get this look 100%. All right, this is my blow dryer. This is my best friend when it comes to my hair. Literally, I can't tell you how much this helps me every single time, because my hair is natural, baby, natural. So apart from that, I had to moisturize my hair. And when it comes to moisturize, I never go wrong when it comes to castor oil. All right, next to me, castor oil. And it really does help me. Right in here we have cactus oil, but this is what I want to tell you. But the original one is the one with, the grease, and that really is the one that I use most of the time. So apart from that, Rattail comb, that's what you need to parten, all your sections and stuff. And I don't know how the shape of how you want it, whether it's triangles, that's exactly what I have in my head right now. Right, or is that you want square, you want a round, how do you want it? Up to you, you are the artist. All right, moving forward is the gummy. I'm sorry, gummy. Woo! There you go. So gummy is what I use because my hair is natural, so the only way for it to slip down is you by using wax. If I use natural gels and stuff, even though eco gel is amazing, but it'll always come out. So this is what I use for this hairstyle. I had needed a brush. Yeah, this brush to brush not really my hair, but to brush my hair as well, but also the extension, all right, that I use for this product. Most important is this one, all right, and this is a crochet stick, and this is amazing. Amazing. You put it in, attach it, pull it out, and then you do your thing. It's amazing, 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 amazing. Really helps me out due to the tangle my hair, my afro hair, and the extension. I needed this, so yeah. Make sure that you don't miss this one. right, to slick my hair, to have everything in place, need a slick brush, whether it's best sometimes either this size or smaller. All right, when it's big, it doesn't help. Next one is the hair. All right, so unless you have long hair, which I don't, all right, because I end up cutting my hair quite short, so obviously I needed extension. And what I use is X-pression, and what you can also use apart from X-pression hair is impression hair. Impression is a little bit more silkier than this one, and you can also use kinky hair. Kinky afro hair is more like a afro textured hair that you can also use to have this look. All right, so unless maybe you want to use like curly hair and twist it up and, you know, roll it around, and yeah, you can use that too. But what I use is expression. And the next thing as well is I use two different colors, and only because I dyed my hair. All right, so my hair is two colors. It's brown and then dark. I'll say dark brown a little bit, but light brown and dark brown. So I got number 4 and I got number 1B mixed in here, and I did it myself. So I mean, once I did it myself, I mean I mixed it both myself. All right, cool. So these are the things that I've used. I believe that I haven't missed on anything. So yeah, bobby pins. Can you see it? But these are the things that help me as well. If you don't have bobby pins, you can always use clippers. All right, help clippers. And these are the ones I got from Superdrug. They help me literally all the time, anytime, whenever I need, what's it called? My hair to be gripped. Next one is gel. And I put just literally towards the end. Let me just hold on to it like that. Alright, and this gel Prink, I've known this for a very, very long time. It's been there for a decade. And this really helped me out towards the end, just to firm a little bit my edges, and that's about it. Oh, I forgot. Two amazing other products is got to be. Alright, so got to be, and I got it for £6.49 for those who live in London, UK. Alright, so got to be straight after, just to lock everything on my hair. And the last thing was, I can't. It's amazing. Yeah, amazing argan oil, replenishing sheen spray. I don't know what, just about to speak Chinese. So cream of nature is really one of my favorite hairspray that I use on my hair. It smells amazing, and it comes out enough really to moisturize your scalp, because your hair, your scalp need to be moisturized. Do not forget that. So this is another protective hairstyle, and honestly, it's like I got inspired by this because it's Bantu knot is basically like a Zulu, you know, Zulu people. They're the one from Southern African origin, you know, for Bantu knots. These are the people who really came up with this hairstyle. So that is the place. So it got spread out everywhere around the world, especially Africans. So you have so many artists, so many people who have done it. Rihanna has done it. I mean, and name it, all right? So it's not bad, right? And let me turn my... All right, so this is it. I hope you really, really like this video. If you did, please give, I mean, you come to the end of the video, you cannot come out of the video without giving a big thumbs up. Please do give a massive big thumbs up. Oh God. Try to share as much as you can. Tell a friend to tell a friend to come in. Probably they'll be interested to, you know, to know how to do this Bantu knot. All right, so what else can I say? Thank you so much for watching. Do not forget to subscribe if you're not yet subscribed, and follow me on my other platforms and my social medias, which I'm gonna put here down below. And to the next video. Love you. Peace out.